If the birds made us terrified of birds, and Jaws made us terrified of sharks, and Poltergeist made us terrified of ghosts, and Jurassic Park made us terrified of dinosaurs, then arachnophobia is what's going to make you terrified of spiders. Even if you're not scared of spiders, you no doubt will be after watching this film. This creepy, crawly comedy thriller shows what happens when a rare and highly deadly spider
from the mountains of South America
accidentally gets transported to a small town in the United States and then breeds with a common house spider, and thus causing a plague of small deadly house spiders which one by one is killing many of the town's residents. The only resident who suspects that the town is being invaded by a new toxic spider breed is Dr. Ross Jennings, played by Jeff Daniels, as in that guy from Dumb and Dumber and Speed. But in true Jaws fashion, the town just thinks he's crazy and no one believes him, on the account that he's new in town. Yeah, stupid doctor people, what do they know? So Jennings is on a race against time to find out where the spider's breeding nest is, to stop this deadly eight-legged carnage in this scary yet funny creature feature, which also features a memorable performance from John Goodman as Delbert the Bug Exterminator.
Yeah, that's right. I'm bad.
Well, guys, it's time to tear out the bad wood and put in good wood as we look into 10 things that you may not know about arachnophobia. The movie that does to spiders what Alien does to, aliens. So sit back and get ready to be creeped and squirm as we check this out. Number 10, directed by a longtime Spielberg collaborator. The movie was directed by first-time director Frank Marshall, but he was no stranger to the world of cinema, as he is a longtime collaborator with Steven Spielberg, having co-produced many great classics such as Raiders of the Lost Ark, Poltergeist, The Color Purple, Back to the Future, and Empire of the Sun, to name but just a few. So I guess that Arachnophobia was his time to branch out and further his career as a director. Steven Spielberg and his Amber Lynn production company were still on board to produce the movie. Marshall would go on to direct Alive and Congo. But I think his true talents lie in producing, as in later years he would produce Hook, The Sixth Sense, The Bourne Identity, and The Curious Case of Benjamin Button. Once again, to name but just a few. Number 9, the film was originally darker. The 1980s was the decade of the horror comedies, thanks to well-loved movies like An American Werewolf in London, Ghostbusters, Fright Night, and Beetlejuice. And so to kickstart the 90s, arachnophobia would have felt right in place and at home with this genre. However, apparently the original script was more darker in tone and more of a straight-up horror movie. Jeff Daniels describes the dialogue in the original script as being written by a robot. And also, according to Daniels, because the story itself wasn't a balls-to-wall horror, the comedy was added in to make it more fulfilling, a roller coaster ride for the audience. Frank Marshall himself admitted that he didn't want the movie to be terrifying, but rather have people laughing while being scared at the same time. And incidentally, when marketed, Arachnophobia was the first movie to be billed as a thrillomedy. I just love the term thrillomedy. If only it could be used more often. Number 8. No spiders were harmed during the making of the movie. During the movie's production, the well-being of the spiders was paramount, and it was important to look after them without any cruelty or harm being inflicted on them. So if a scene required a spider meeting its maker, certain tricks had to be used, such as using rubber spiders. And in the scene where the John Goodman Delbert character steps on a spider, the effect was achieved by using a hollowed-out shoe, so no contact would be made with the spider. Goodman even joked that there was more safety and care put into the spiders than there was the human actors. Still, whoever stood on that spider with the hollowed out shoe still would have had their foot come into contact with a spider. Ugh. Number 7, the main spider actually has a name. So in Arachnophobia, there is something of a main villain in the form of the giant spider from Venezuela, known as the General. This giant, no-nonsense spider wants nothing more than to breed and to destroy Jeff Daniels. However, behind the scenes, the General Spider was given a name. Yep, the bird-eating tarantula was known on the set as Big Bob. And in case you were wondering, he got his name from Back to the Future director Robert Zemeckis. So, why was this bird-eating tarantula named after Robert Zemeckis? Well, this is because... I don't know. Reasons? When Arachnophobia was released on VHS, it mentioned Back to the Future on the cover, saying it had the excitement of said movie. So could that have something to do with it? I don't know, this is one mystery I can't figure out. It actually still says it now here on the DVD cover. Number 6, Tough Competition. Despite the fact that Arachnophobia was a huge hit with fans when it was released and even won a series of awards, it still couldn't beat its box office competitors, as Arachnophobia came third behind the supernatural romantic thriller Ghost and the action-packed spectacle Die Hard 2. But still, coming in third in the box office isn't bad for a directional debut. Heck, the movie even got two thumbs up from Siskel and Ebert. But regardless, I guess that in 1990, moviegoers were too caught up watching Bruce Willis being a smart mouth at an airport, and Patrick Swayze coming back from the dead to sort out Willie Lopez. Maybe they can combine the three movies, and have John McClane come after Willie Lopez after shooting a heap of spiders in a dark alleyway. Number 5. Filming locations. Most of the movie was shot in Cambria, California, which is no surprise as many Spielberg productions back in those days did often take place in California. However, what may come as a surprise is the location that was used at the start of the movie. The movie begins in South America with a wildlife insect expedition. Scenes from this part of the movie were actually filmed in Venezuela, in the Canaima National Park to be precise. Of which Arachnophobia is the first ever movie production to use this exotic and beautiful location for filming. So if it wasn't for Arachnophobia, some of this beautiful scenery may never have been seen. But thankfully it was put on film for the whole world to enjoy. And having the movie feature such exotic locations just makes the movie feel that bit more polished and spectacular with more momentum. Number 4, video game. Yeah, this took me by surprise too, but apparently Arachnophobia got its own video game. Released in 1991 for the Commodore 64, the first thing that strikes me about this game is just how darn good the graphics are. They are top notch. I love this shot of Big Bob approaching the town. It looks frickin' epic. And it has this thing where you look at different species of spiders, and it even follows the movie by explaining that the General came from South America. So in the game, you play as John Goodman's Delbert character, and your job is to go around people's homes exterminating the deadly spiders seen in the movie. Yep, Dr. Ross Jennings had been scrapped, and now it's all up to Delbert. And just like the movie itself, it's actually pretty creepy. It's a shame this game never took off, because Delbert could have been a classic video game icon. Oh yes, Mario, Sonic, and Delbert.
What a shame.
And when you die, you're greeted with this shocking piece of imagery. Look at this! It's terrifying! If I had played this game when I was a kid, this no doubt would have made me piss my pants. Ugh. Number 3, Help from a Mythbuster. Certain shots of Big Bob, the main spider, required the use of a mechanical spider puppet in order to get close-ups and for it to do certain maneuvers that the real spider wouldn't be able to do. And believe it or not, the spider puppet seen in the movie was created by Jamie Hyneman, of which everyone would come to know Hyman and his epic mustache in Mythbusters. So long before Hyman was debunking famous myths and legends, he was building creepier-than-hell spiders for Arachnophobia. Number 2, the spiders that were used. Many of the smaller spiders seen in Arachnophobia were in fact a species called Avondale spiders, which come from New Zealand, 347 to be precise, all of which had to stay in America after filming due to quarantine purposes. They are a harmless species and were provided by a research group from Auckland. However, Big Bob was played by a real tarantula, when he wasn't a robot puppet, that is, and he was the only tarantula of his kind in the country at that time. And of course, some of the spiders that were used in the movie were even spiders that had previously died, with just their bodies being used.
Which is kind of morbid when you think about it.
Number 1, a producer thought that Arachnophobia ripped off his work. In 1977, producer Igo Cantor produced a movie called Kingdom of Spiders, advertising itself as a science fiction nightmare. Kingdom of the Spiders does bear many similarities to Arachnophobia, in that they are both movies about small American towns getting terrorized by a plague of deadly spiders. However, in an interview with Fangora magazine, Cantor expressed that he felt Arachnophobia was a blatant copy of Kingdom of the Spiders, but further joked that he wouldn't sue, as that would involve suing Arachnophobia's producer, who was Steven Spielberg, and he went on to say, just how on earth does anyone sue Spielberg? Well, in my opinion, maybe it could just be possible that someone else made a Deadly Plague of Spiders movie. After all, spiders are one of the most common fears ever.
Okay guys, that was my look into Arachnophobia, the terrifying but yet still humorous movie about why we should all hate spiders. Even though we really shouldn't, because they still do good things for the environment and shit. To me, there has never been a spider movie quite as effective as Arachnophobia. Not before, and not since. Anyway, I'm Minty, and if your town ever gets invaded by killer spiders, maybe listen to your town's doctor rather than laugh and joke about him and nickname him Dr. Death. You know, just an idea. See ya!